Hello, brave explorers. I'm your host, the Crazy Canadian Lego Critic, and today we have a gigantic set here to review. We have a very large set. Today we're reviewing Lego Pharaoh's Quest. Blah! 7327 Scorpion Pyramid, 792 pieces. Wow, look at the size of this box. I haven't reviewed a set of this size in quite a while, so this is going to be a bit of a treat. A lot of action, a lot of guns, a lot of explosions, holy smokes, giant scorpions, Anubis people, Amset Ra, holy smokes, we got some pretty crazy stuff going on here. Back of the box, just everything that's going on. I love how his tail is hiding number two. We don't like two. Lots of action and craziness going on, and lots of really interesting stuff going on, so this will be a fun set to review. Oh, and my TV's gone for reasons, so I'll explain a little bit. Here's instruction book number one, first page. Yeah, Amset Ra, you don't get him right off the bat. You get him later on in the build. Let's go to a random page of you building the pyramid. Total of 75 pages and a really, really cool look, like a poster for a movie or something like that. And we have page number two, first page, and this one has 79 pages in it. No, 82. Yeah, 82 pages. So this will be my subscriber appreciation episode because you guys are awesome, and we have 300 subscribers. So this is my 300 subscriber review. So this will be fun because we got a lot of really neat minifigures going on. First off, we'll start off with our hero Jake Reins. Again, that those sideburns are ridiculous. Worst Elvis impersonator ever. He's cool as always. It's a good minifigure to have. But oh, the sideburns. They make Philip Quast jealous. Next up we have the mechanic, and he's not as much an exclusive as he's rare, because his hat only appears in this one set. And he's pretty cool looking. He's got grease or mummy blood? I don't know. Back's really cool. I don't remember this guy's name, but if anybody can put it down, that'd be nice. He's really cool looking. Scruffy old mechanic. Next up, we have Archibald Hale, I believe. He's a professor at a university, and he's really studious. He's exclusive to this set, and he is really, really cool looking. Figures. Alright, he's in. Alright. Already we're having pieces flying all over the place. He has another really cool map. No idea if it is exclusive or not, but it's really cool looking. He comes with a nice little light beige handbag, and he's really cool looking. So we've done our heroes. Now the star attractions of this set, the villains, the Anubis guys. Oh my gosh. I couldn't have asked for a better looking minifigure, even if I tried. These guys are just so menacing and so awesome looking at the same time. And you get two. Two of them. Holy smokes. Lego was best move I've seen in a long time by Lego. Really, really awesome and really menacing looking. I would not want to see one of those things if I was walking around a pyramid. We also get the main villain, Amset Ra, mummy from the grave. He has special bandaging. Because he's the Pharaoh, you know. And I guess this was the Pharaoh from the minifig series 2 when, after like a 100 and some odd years later. And another really cool thing, he's got a golden mask. He is the Pharaoh. Look at him. He's the Pharaoh from the minifig series 2. He's not happy. He is not happy. He's a grumpy guy. And this headpiece, it's the magical headpiece that lets him see into the future, supposedly. But we all know it's just for show. And we got a flying mummy. Ridiculous, yes, but really, really cool. He does have a double-sided head. And yeah, he's just really cool looking. I like these flying mummies. Ridiculous concept. Yes. Oh gosh, minifigs are flying everywhere already. I'm gonna cut that. Okay, sorry for the second delay, but I've been just having to fix some, grab some pieces, because, oh gosh, I almost had another mistake. So, we have our minifigures, and I'm going to have to say right now, great selection. A lot of really cool, lots of rare minifigures. You got one, two, three exclusives, one uncommon, no, two uncommon, yeah, well, you got a couple, okay, one, two, three, four, no, one, two, three, four exclusives, one uncommon, and one common. So that's a good sign right there that we're going into good territory. So we're going to set up our guys, and we're going to go on to the actual temple itself, because I'm thinking you guys are going to be really interested in this. Okay, so we have all of our guys in place here, as you can see. We're going to go through the little bits. So, of course, our adventurers need to get somewhere, our heroes, so they call upon the handy-dandy desert trekking car of awesomeness. Treads, check. Giant gun, check. Awesome back, guns, and pickaxe. This is an awesome car. I love the design. I'm surprised Lego would put such a humongous gun on the back of a car. And you got enough room to fit all of your adventurers, except for one. But, you know, she's not here at the moment. She's off doing something else. I have no idea what she's doing. But the car itself is really, really nice in a nice dark red. And it's just awesome. It's just really, really cool looking. I got nothing else to say, but it's pretty cool. So you're coming up to the temple. And right off the bat, you notice, oh my gosh, stickers everywhere. Oh gosh, we are in trouble now. Okay, so you're coming up, and first thing you notice, besides this giant statue, or is it, these pits. Now, these pits have, well, the first one has coins and stuff in it. And this one over here has snakes. Now, why there's pits just randomly put all over the place is beyond me. I mean, why? Why would you put pits outside of the temple? I have no idea why. Maybe it's because you want them to hear them scream. You want to hear the rest of the kingdom scream, oh my gosh, I'm dying! Ah, let them hear you, fool. But it's just a really weird decision. And I think it would have been better to put like the Anubis statues or something like that. That probably would have been a better choice. Or even cover this up, so have like a secret, so you open it up and there's the scorpions and stuff down there. Like they did with the Sphinx secret surprise. Oop, I'm mentioning adventurers. Shouldn't be doing that. Nice obelisk here. No idea why there's an obelisk. Just a nice showpiece. A good obelisk. And so we're going along and you notice, oh, there's something in the back there. We'll go to that in a bit. So you're moving along and all of a sudden, oh my gosh, giant scorpion comes to life. This thing, holy smokes. Another awesome showpiece. All the pieces on him are printed. Thank you, Lego. You lots of stickers, but you at least put printing on something. You guys are so nice. He is really cool looking. Lego's always done brick-built creatures very well. He's got a nice little stinger on the end of his tail. He's pretty poseable. He walks around. His pinchers are really menacing. And he overall is really, really cool looking. So let's say you kill that thing. You managed to kill it. So you and your buddy, so we'll take Jake, because I have no idea why. And you go up the temple stairs. You're going up, and all of a sudden, whoosh! Yeah, the stairs go up. I'm maining stairs, roar! I mean, why couldn't the stairs go down? Wouldn't that make more sense? I have no idea why, but it's more or less like a secret compartment. You can hide treasure in there. Jake reigns, he's finally had enough, he is going to go down and have a cry. Well, that's all the time we have right now, so tune in for part 2, where we're going to continue on, and we're actually going to go inside the temple. I'll see you guys in a bit.